Back at the bench with another fun kit, Revell USA's Camaro concept car in 1/25th scale. Skill level 3 has 43 parts. Let's take a look at everything inside that sweet looking box when you get yours. First up will be the two decal sheets. We got a water slide decal sheet with a ton of detail. Nice pinstriping, nice hockey stripes there. Chevy emblems down to the marker lights and even gauges. Yes, on a snap tight kit, even gauges. And then we have the vinyl applique decals. And those look lovely. Those are for the beginners if you want to use them. Or for you experienced guys if you just want a nice fast build. We've got four nice rubber tires with beautiful tread pattern. There is no brand name. And it's so skinny you wouldn't notice anyways. So those are the concept Camaro style tires. Let's get, oh yeah, yep. Big chassis. Look at all the detail on that. Snap tight kit. We got the nice engine we can paint. We got the nice exhaust. We got our axle back here. Everything looks sweet on that. We can give this a little detail and bring that right out, or we can leave it black if we so choose. We've got individual brake discs with calipers. Those are definitely getting painted up. We've got the nice double grills, the lower air intake and the upper grill. We've got our steering wheel. So you kiddos can pick this up and know you can get it together all by yourselves. We've got the nice glass here that we'll be taking out, but that's pad printed. And then we've got our headlights in large assemblies and our fog lights, so we can't lose those easily. Also included are some metal axles and some small screws to get the body connected to the chassis. Let's take a look at that body. It is molded in a beautiful metallic green, and you know what that means on the workshop. When we have beautiful plastic, I love that style molding. We're just going to clear coat this and bring that metallic out, and it's going to look wonderful. So it's got every bit of the shape of that concept Camaro. It is a curbside, so there are no engine details aside from what's on the bottom of the chassis, and that's completely fine. It still makes for a beautiful concept Camaro model. Let's get all the rest of the plastic out here. We'll go to there, we got there, we got... We even have tinted taillights on a snap tight kit. Awesome. We've got the rear spoiler. I will be cleaning that up. It's got a little bit of flash. I'll be cleaning that up and attaching that to the body before we clear it. Also, we've got the mirrors. I will be attaching those, pushing them in, then we'll clear it so they're all cleared at the exact same time. And then all I'll have to do is color in the reverse layer, the mirrors, with some Molotow chrome. They will absolutely fit the part. We've got a lovely dashboard. When they introduced it, those dash gauges will go in there. A little bit of picking out of some silver accents will make that dash stand right out. And we will be doing some paint work on this kit, so don't worry about that either. We've got the nice door panels, beautifully molded. We've got our seat backs. We've got our interior tub, the 2+2 setup. It's even got corrugated floors down there. Here, that's pretty cool. We got the nice center console, which could use a little bit of detailing. So we've got everything looking lovely. We've got our seats, which need a coat of paint and then some future to give them more of that leathery look to them. And then we've got our wheels. We've got our reflective surfaces for the lights. We've got our exhaust tips right here. We've got our fuel cap. We've got, what is this, a shifter, and we've got the massive open wheels. That's why I'm doing those brakes. Now, in the concept car, the wheels aren't chrome, so I'm going to be fixing that as well. I'm going to get these parts together, and we're going to come back for a subassembly show-off. Once again, on these snap tights, boy, the subassembly before I want to put some paint on it is just exhausting. I had to actually take my fingers and press in the rear spoiler, which fits in beautifully. Not a drop of adhesive needed, and mold seamlessly into that body, which looks awesome. The only thing I need to do to this body from now on is put the glass in, and we're ready to go. I'm also going to take a black Sharpie while the paint on all this other stuff is drying, and I'm going to make some rubber trim around the windows. And the reason I'm doing that is the concept car I saw did have that. The main, I'm going to loose fit the glass and see if it helps. Otherwise, I will also take the black Sharpie and draw a very light line right on the edge all the way around all the windows to give us that rubber gasket material that they would use on a car like this that they use on modern cars and everything. In the old days, I used the silver Sharpie to do the chrome press-in trim over the rubber gasket like they always used to use, but nowadays it's almost all black rubber vinyl gasketing, so that's what I'll be doing with that body while the paint is drying. I have decided, after looking at some pictures of some concept Camaros, that it wasn't exactly a perfect black. Well, they have variations of it, and it's, you know, so it wasn't a perfect black inside. So what I'm going to do is all the interior pieces, I've got the seats pushed together, and I did run a little bead of glue on those just so those backs didn't fall off when I was messing around with stuff. I'm going to take all the interior pieces, the steering wheel, the door panels, the dash, the tub, and that, and I'm going to give them a very dark charcoal color, but not all the way black. One, because this car will be pretty dark inside to begin with, and I want things to stand out when you look through the windows. Also, because what I'll do is I'll spray everything with black primer, and that gives it a rough surface and a little bit of a tooth. Then we'll go ahead and we'll do that grayish interior, that dark charcoal, almost black but not quite, that will show up nicer on a scale model. Then I will take some future floor polish on that paint, and I will accentuate the seats and the dash so that they look like they're made out of a shinier material than the carpets and the back deck lid and all that. So that's going to be fun. These beautiful brake rotors that we're going to be able to see so easily behind those wheels. I'm going to paint these metallic. Then I'm going to highlight the brake calipers. Now, I didn't see in the concept what color they were. I didn't have any really amazing car show shots of the brakes, but I'm going to try to find a green that will go behind there and accent that, or some other sort of accent color. Of course, red would always look good on calipers, but if I can find a nice green instead, I'll go ahead and do that. So all this stuff's gonna get primered in black, especially the chassis, to tone that plastic tone down. Then the wheels here, I removed our reflective surfaces for behind the lights. I've got our exhaust tips, our gas cap, our shifter, and our wheels, none of which looked chrome to me on the show cars. So if you want to take this a little further, if you put this on the car as it is, they're going to look fantastic. But for me, if you want to take it a little further, I didn't see really any chrome on the show car. So I'm going to black primer all of this. I'm going to go through a lot of black primer today to begin with. And then I'm going to give these a silver paint coating so that they're more of a anodized or painted aluminum wheel, like the concept car and the art and the pictures I saw. So let's go over to the paint area and start getting some color on stuff. All the paint is dry, so let's talk about some stuff that I do when I paint these kits. I usually just show the parts, but let's discuss it a little bit. We have time and a snap review. As you can see, my method of madness with a lot of stuff. This was black plastic. It looked like this when we started. Super shiny. I primered it black, and then I sprayed it with that Valspar blindfold color, a dark charcoal. Now, if you just spray over the top, you'll actually get it to leave all that black in the back for you. All that shadowing is now done. It just needs a decal, and I can black wash the lower grill to make it look like it's all set up. And then our work is done. If you were to get a lot of gray inside there, but it won't if you just give it light coats. If you hose it down, and I know it looks like I'm painting heavy coats, in the videos. You can't look at that. That's a lot of light. That is a wet coat. That is different angles and stuff. So don't assume that I'm completely hosing the parts down. You're going to see. But you get it to leave the black in there, and that looks really awesome, and that's what I like. And we got the steering wheel that color. We'll be able to detail that a little bit. We'll be able to black wash in there. And we've got an awesome looking grill underneath that green body. We've got the same with the seats. We sprayed it black to give that plastic some tooth. A lot of times when you use the Rust-Oleum brand, we'll go over stuff bare plastic real easy and stick. It's a thicker paint. The Krylons and the Valspars that I get from like Lowe's, those tend to be much thinner, and without something there on a very smooth plastic, it will pull away from all the sharp edges and give you a kind of a weird effect. Sometimes that worked great, like in a military model for weathering. That is awesome to leave it that way, but other times I want it to actually fill in. Now you can see on the dashboard here, it still allows all the detail without any of it being hidden. In the interior, gorgeous. I'm just going to be hand painting the floorboards black for black carpet, but otherwise we'll be putting those nice door panels in with all their detail. That's got all of our shadows and everything in it, because I went over it with the black primer first and then mist coated over the top of these, gave it enough of a charcoal color so that it contrasts and it's not so dark inside, but when we do seal it up, it will be dark. That gray-ish, darker gray will give us a better tonal variation inside. Let's talk metallics. I love metallic spray paints. I buy and experiment with all different types of metallics, because metallic is a hard paint to get to work right, and a lot of these bigger companies have really perfected the techniques. Now, this here are the brake rotors. Now I'll be hand painting the rotors, of course, and doing a black wash around them all the way. And then these will be behind those big wheels. And that is going to look great back there, okay? That's going to look so authentic. That kind of a color, can you see the larger metallic flakes in it? That's the effect I want on something like a brake rotor. So on something like that, I will pick one of the Rust-Oleum metallics. And you can kind of see in the plastic that it's got a larger flake color. That's called satin nickel, and that's what we used on that. For smaller grits, we want to use something, we want more detail to show. We don't want as much of a metal flake. I like using this on exhausts, on engine blocks, stuff like that, where you really want that raw metal. You know, I use this a lot in that 934 review. These brand metallics, the Universals, they worked really cool to bring out detail on that engine. On stuff like a wheel, I don't want as big of a flake. This was all painted black and then repainted, and you can see, if you throw the paint on nicely, look at the amazing shadows. Now, this is painted right over the chrome. Look at the amazing shadows you get. I don't have to black wash that. I don't have to detail that. One coat of primer, one coat of spray can paint, and all that work is done for me that other people will spend a very long time getting that same effect, and that looks amazing. Now, that looks a lot like the wheels. That looks a lot like those wheels, that metallic look to me. In scale, tilt it to the side with that black primer, and then you mist coat it. You see you get all those shadows on the inside as well when you tilt it to the side. It doesn't look as toyish. It's amazing. That is a new paint I just happened to come across. Krylon Brilliant Aluminum, and it's in a massive can for $4 at Walmart. I just experimented with it. Normally, I would use Rust-Oleum Metallic Aluminum, and they're 2X. That is another very fine one, and I like this for newer type exhausts and a lot of headers that I'm going to detail. But I experimented with this, and what a happy surprise, because this, even though they look the same, will give you two different tones coming out. All right, you've seen my other reviews. This is one of my new favorite metallic ones for wheels now. Another one that I love absolutely using all the time, you've seen me use it a lot, I gave Rust-Oleum Bright Coat Chrome a chance. Literally called Bright Coat Chrome. I picked this up, $4 a can at Wally World. They always have it in stock. I gave it a try, and that's what I use all the time for all my chrome work, and I love it. This thing has changed my life. with chrome on model kits, because this to me in scale looks more like real chrome than the chromed parts do to me. And I use this all the time. You see me mention in every review. So those are my metallics. These are the painted parts of the kits. Go out if you like those looks, snag the paints. If you don't like them, don't buy them, whatever you like. But that's what I use, and I get lots of questions on it. All I have to do now is I'm going to start detailing some stuff on the dashboard. I'm going to get the gauges in there. I'm going to get the steering wheel on. I'm going to get the interior all put together, and we'll come back for another peep. Loving my little Snap-Tite Max Camaro kit. I've got the chassis painted, we've got the exhaust and the engine and transaxle done in two different metallic colors. Choose whatever you think you like best, get that done. We've got our brake rotors done. Did three types of paint treatment on those. We did that main spray. Then I painted the calipers a nice gloss green, a darker green than the body. And then I took a silver marker, a silver Sharpie, and did the inside. Then I blackwashed all the rotor holes. So those are going to look awesome. That's going to look like the fresh rotor. That's going to look like the actual used, shiny, glazed rotor on there. That's going to be great behind those enormous wheels and tires. When you put the wheels and tires on, when you do the back tire, when you do the front tire, they are directional. So make sure that you have two sides out and you have all the tires going in the same arrow pattern. Molotow chrome on those mirror surfaces, those are ready to push in. I blackwashed inside the exhaust tips, those are ready to push in. We've got our chrome for the backing of our lights. We got our lights right there. Those are just going to snap in. I left most of the grill alone, except I blackwashed the very bottom part to darken that up. So when that's behind the body, that will look great. We got our tail lights to go in. We got our glass to drop in. The interior is all done, and I just love it. Lots of detail on there. Things I used to detail the interior was mostly just a silver gel pen. Any craft store will have them. Go ahead and highlight everything in there and then polish it up with future floor polish just on the seats. And that gave me the rougher texture of the plastic that they would have used all the way around, the higher quality plastics. Then I glossed up the dashboard just a little bit along with the seats to make them stand out. And I did black carpet on the bottom. You can barely see it. We've got our dash decals in there, and then I did a little bit of black washing and silver trim on the dashboard to bring that out. That's a stunning looking dashboard. I did the door handles with silver trim, did the inserts on the doors with a little bit of future floor polish to darken them up, but otherwise that's all one shade of gray sprayed on, and you can get it to have subtle color differentiations, tonal variations, and with that black carpet, she looks awesome inside there. The body I've been working on, I've got my door panel lines in, I've got my fender louvers painted in, I've got my trim done. I used markers for all of it, and I even snapped in the gas cap after I blackwashed it. Looks nice there. But yeah, I used Sharpie markers, black markers for all the rubber trim, all the way around. Did it with that. For the different panel lines on the car, I used these awesome Blackliners available from modelroundup.com. Just go on there. They're made by Molotow, the exact same company that makes the chrome pens. And I did the fender louvers in the darker black. And those look great just the way they are. Then I took a Gundam marker. These are available anywhere Bandai Gundam models are sold. And this is another fine tip marker in a very light gray. Because I didn't want to do such strong panel lines like I have in the fenders on the rest of the vehicle. I just wanted a hint. So I did and drew all those out, the door handles and everything. The nice thing about this Gundam marker and these Molotow markers is they are water soluble until they are dried. So if you run outside the lines, I did all the way around here, I did all the way in the trunk, just subtle enough to bring them out and give us a little detail. Did the hood all the way around, very, very subtle, but just enough to notice. Those, if you make a mistake, unlike a Sharpie marker, which is on and on for good without a serious amount of work, they can do it and then wipe it off. You just lick your finger, rub it off, and it'll stay in the lower points of the doors and the seams, and it will rub off the rest of the body. So I'm going to press everything together, put the glass in, put the interior in. I'm going to get the decals on, and we will be back. Some of you have been asking for quite a while even though I've talked about it and I've actually shown it on camera a couple times, but some of you have said, how do I apply the future to a model car? How do I get it on there? Now, there's many ways to do it, but I almost always hand brush it. It's that simple. I've got my Pledge Floor Care with Future Finish Shine. The label has changed, but it's still the exact same stuff in these kind of bottles at Walmart for less than $7. This container here has got to be 5-6 years old, and that's all I've used out of it. And I'm building almost 100 models a year, so you don't need to go out and buy a case of this stuff. I like to pour it into a larger cup, doesn't matter. I take a brush, usually a synthetic because they shed hair a lot less. And the technique is exactly like I tell you. When I tell you guys how I do something, I'm not making it up or saying, oh, it's, you know, it's exactly how I do it. I have no reason not to share with you. So dip your brush in your cup of future like you're actually going to paint it. And now we're going to paint the entire car with future floor polish and just cover the whole thing. Let it run down. I try to avoid the tires most of the time because I'm not a big armor all in the tire kind of a guy. But just go ahead and brush it all over the car, right over your glass, right over your decals, and that's it. That's literally how it's done. There's no secret. There's no problems. There's no lying about it. Nothing. We just brush it on the car. Over everything. Give it a nice coat. Don't dip the car in it. Don't be silly. Just give it a nice coat of future. We go all the way around. We do the mirrors. We do over the glass. We do the joins. And it will bring out the shine in any material you use it on. Plastic, paint. This is safe for any kind of paint, any kind of material, anything you want to put it on. You're going to get a beautiful shine from it. It's safe for chrome. It's safe for metallic paints. It's like a little miracle fluid. And I really like it. And I just brush it on and cover it up and get it on there. And we go over the sides and we go over the decals and over the mirrors and over the glass joins and get it all on there. And that's it. All right, I've applied future to this model. You need to just stop touching it and walk away for a couple hours. Overnight's, you know, good, but a couple hours is fine. It'll be pretty hard. And then that's it. You're all done. Now, when it starts to dry, you're going to notice that anywhere it's a little thicker, it's going to start turning white, very milky. Don't touch it. Don't apply more. Don't screw around with it. Don't fight it. Don't freak out. Don't send me nasty messages. Walk away from it. That white spot will clear. It'll be just fine. Chill. Have a nice time. Go have a Coke and a smile. You're not going to have a problem with it. You're just going to put it on and let it run over the model. Wipe it level. Just give it a nice layer of it and go away and come back, and you're going to see that you have a beautiful shine on your kit. So when I come back, we'll have the final. And just like that, as easy as that, you can have an awesome looking concept Camaro to memorialize when they brought back the Camaros. All right, this is a sweet model. The detail is top notch. Yes, it's a press fit kit. You know, when you think snap tight, you think low detail, but come on folks, the modern ones, awesome machines with a little bit of work, a little bit of panel line detailing, the beautiful water slides. If you're not experienced with decals, go ahead, use the stick on stickers, but just a little bit of paint and detail on the interior. Didn't even have to paint the body because it comes in a beautiful metallic green plastic, accented with just a little bit of work, and everything looks awesome. Let's lift it up here and get it a little closer. You can see how cool those brakes come out. Definitely worth detailing the brakes under the car. Of course, we've got our under chassis detail like we showed before. But yeah, definitely worth picking this one up. There will be a link in the description where you can get yours on order to get one. And you can see, you know, you can have a lot of fun with it. I even decided to mask off the back end and paint that lower valance with just craft paint and then futured over it. It's really easy to do, so we added all those details. We used our Molotow Blackliner pens for things like the intake on the front of the hood, for our side stripes in front of our fenders, And then we use that nice lighter colored gray marker to get our panel lines in there so it looks awesome. There will be a slideshow after this. I say pick up two of these, let the kiddos build one, you build one and go extra detail, and that way you can put them side by side and get people into the hobby and say, now see, the Snaptite was fun, and if you just put a couple more hours worth of work into it, you can have a really nice curbside model of a brand new modern car, and modern cars are what the kids like. So go ahead, pick this up. You can teach them how to use stickers, you can teach them how to use decals. There's a million levels of potential in an awesome kit like this. As always, I thank you for watching the workshop. We'll see you at the next review. Let the haters be your motivators. Have fun with your model kits and keep a smile on your face while building.